The training data used here is x1 and x2. So if either or both x1 and x2 is 0, then this would give us 0. And if both x1 and x2 are 1, then this would give us 1. So this is the target result. And we will start by randomly initializing the weights. So here we have two weights, W1 and W2. And after that, we will go into a loop where we would first calculate the weighted sum. So WS is equal to W1 times X1 plus W2 times X2. And second, we will apply an activation function. And in this case, we are using a step function. So if the resulting WS is bigger than 1, then the result would equal to 1. Otherwise, if the resulting WS is smaller or equal to 1, then the result would be 0. And third, we would determine the error. And the error is equal to the target result minus the result. So this target result minus this result. And fourth, we would adjust the weights. So the adjusted W1 would equal to the learning rate times the error from here times X1 plus the original W1. And same thing for W2. And the learning rate is the rate at which the neural network learns, and it ranges from 0 to 1. And we repeat steps 1 through 4 for all vectors in the training data, for all those vectors. So this is one epoch. So an epoch is one pass through all training vectors. And we will also have an outer loop where we would loop through additional epochs until the error is equal to 0 for all training vectors in the final epoch. So the objective is to determine what weights, in this case what W1 and W2, would lead to the target result equaling to the result for all those vectors. Next, I'll go ahead and demo the application before writing it step by step. So we went from epoch 0, where the target result in this vector is 1 and the result is 0, so the error is 1. And we went to epoch 4, where the target result is equal to the result for all training vectors. So we have error is 0 everywhere here. And if we run it again, we'll get to from epoch 0 to epoch 9 with the same thing. Next, I will start by creating a new Java project. And here I will have two classes, a perceptron, and this is an artificial neuron modeling a biological one. And I will have it in this package. And I will also have a driver class with a main method. And in the perceptron class, I will define this three-dimensional array for the end training data. And I will define this learning rate, and I'll set it to 0.05 for the purpose of this tutorial. And I will have this initial weights array, where I would randomly initialize W1 and W2 to a number between 0 and 1. And here I will need three methods, one of them for calculating the weighted sum, return 0 for now, and another one for applying the activation function, and let's also return 0 for now. And a third one for adjusting the weights, and let's return null for now. And in the driver class, in the main method, I'll pick up the three-dimensional array for the training data and the array for the weights, so perceptron.initialweights, and I will also instantiate both a driver class and a perceptron class. And coming back to the perceptron class, for the calculate weighted sum, let me define this weighted sum and return it. But before doing that, I have a loop here where I will be doing the weighted sum is equal to W1 times X1, or in this case X1 times W1 plus X2 times W2. And for apply activation function, we have a step function here. So I'll define this result and return it. So if the weighted sum is bigger than 1, then the result will be 1. Otherwise, the result will be 0. And for the adjust weights method, I'll have this array adjusted weights that will have W1 and W2, the adjusted W1 and W2. And I will return it. But before doing that, I will calculate those adjusted W1 and W2 by using learning rate times error times X1 plus W1, and learning rate times error times X2 plus W2. And that's all what I need for this class. So let's go to the driver class. And here, let's define an error flag. And I will have a while loop where I will be training the neural network and stop when there is no errors remaining. And I will have this print heading method that will print the heading and the epoch number that's passed in. And we will call this method from here. So let's define epoch number here and start it from zero. And for that epoch, I will loop through all vectors in the training data. Where I will calculate the weighted sum and apply the activation function to that weighted sum. And let me define this error over here. And I will calculate that error, and let's set the error flag to false initially, and if the error is different than zero, then I will set that error flag to true, and let me define this adjusted weights array, and go ahead and adjust the weights, and let me set error to zero over here, and let me have this print vector method. And I will be calling it from here. And last thing I'm gonna do is to set the weights to the adjusted weights. So this should do it. And lastly, let me go ahead and test run the application. So we went from epoch 0 to epoch 4.